Hello. First of all, I would like to thank the organizing committee to give me the opportunity to present our research work, ionic liquids for new thermoelectrochemical cells, or thermocells. This study was carried out owing to the collaboration between two French research groups from the University of Paris-Saclay, IGC Lab, and the French Alternative Energies and Atomic Energy Commission. As it is well known, energy production and consumption are accompanied by significant heat losses. However, this waste heat could be an important electric power source via the Seebeck effect. In such a context, our study is devoted to the development of new thermoelectrochemical cells, serving for the direct conversion of waste heat into electricity at small scales. For example, in portable settings or in conjunction with larger power generation sources. A classical thermoelectrochemical cell consists of two identical electrodes immersed in electrolyte containing a redox couple. A gradient of temperature is applied across the cell, and the generated potential difference between the two electrodes is associated with the entropy of the redox reaction, which takes place at the electrode-electrolyte interfaces. The magnitude of this effect is described by the Seebeck coefficient. The reference system for all thermocells is an aqueous solution of ferrofluorcyanide ions, which shows a relatively high Seebeck coefficient of about 1.4 mV per Kelvin, one order higher than that given by semiconductor materials. However, until relatively recent advance in the field, the conversion efficiency and power output of thermocells were very low due to the physicochemical properties of water solutions. The current research focuses on the development of new redox couples of and non-volatile and thermally stable electrolytes, such as ionic liquids, as well as on the nanostructure of electrodes to improve the performance of thermocells. Our study concerns the application of the 1-ethyl-3-methylimidazolium ionic liquid in thermocells. Among other ionic liquids, this one has a sufficiently high ionic conductivity and low viscosity, and its properties could be further improved by the introduction of co-solvents or other additives. Moreover, the use of ionic liquids, known as the highly structured environments, may result in larger entropy changes upon redox reactions via solvation reorganization phenomena, leading to the higher Seebeck coefficient values. The second important issue is to find an appropriate redox couple for the thermocells. We were drawn to the literature data on the redox chemistry of europium species in ionic liquids. It has been described as the apparent standard redox potential of the europium-3-europium-2 redox couple strongly depends on the temperature, and its variation achieves the extraordinary values of about 10 mV per Kelvin. Our goal was to understand better this phenomenon and to use the obtained knowledge in the development of new efficient thermocells. As a trivalent source of europium and bromides, we have used the commercial salts. Solution of europium through triflamide were obtained by electrolysis. We have used a 3-electrode cell placed in a glove box under an argon atmosphere, as the formed europium 2 species can be easily reoxidized by oxygen. The successful complete reduction of europium 3 to europium 2 was proved by cyclic voltammetry studies performed before and after electrolysis, as well as by UV-visible spectrophotometry. The observed absorption bands are related to the presence of europium 2 species in solution, according to the literature data. We have also verified a long-term chemical stability of divalent europium in anhydrous and hydrated ionic liquid solutions. No changes in absorption spectra were detected on the scale of several months in the absence of oxygen. The measurements of the Seebeck coefficient were done in a homemade small-volume thermocell with glassy carbon electrodes. In a typical experiment, the position of a cell was vertical. The upper electrode was heated and the bottom electrode was cooled. The cell was placed in a Faraday cage to minimize electrical noises. The open circuit voltage was unregistered by means of the high input impedance electrometer. The measurements were carried out during several days. The applied gradient of temperature across the cell was between 5 and 20 degrees. In addition to the measurements of the open circuit potential, we have also performed the electrochemical characterization of the studied systems to detect undesired electrochemical processes, as well as to obtain the data on electrochemical kinetics of the europium-3-europium-2 redox reaction and the diffusion transport of europium species. First of all, we have studied europium-3 solutions in anhydrous ionic liquid media. We have found that the reduction of europium-3 triflamide complex is an irreversible process on a glassy carbon electrode at low temperatures, while the increase of the temperature up to 40 degrees of Celsius or the addition of bromides in solution leads to the quasi-irreversible process. The observed Seebeck coefficient was about 1.5 mV per Kelvin in the absence of bromides. The similar values for the reference system, but very, very small in the presence of bromides. We have decided to verify if the strong Seebeck effects reported in the literature are related to the presence of water in anionic liquid solutions, as the hydrated salts of europium were used. We have performed a voltammetric study of europium solutions in the ionic liquid at different water content. We have observed the shift of reduction potential in a cathodic direction with the increase of water content, as well as the improvement of the reversibility of electrochemical process. The current decrease is related to the lower viscosity of ionic liquid water mixtures, and consequently to the higher diffusion coefficient of europium species. The measured Seebeck coefficients were quite high in ionic liquid water mixtures, overpassing 4 mV per Kelvin in all cases. It may be explained by a large entropy change upon the redox reaction involving the mixed triflamide water complexes of europium. The more difficult situation was observed for the solution of europium in the hydrated ionic liquid in the presence of bromides. In this case, the Seebeck coefficient was dependent on the mean cell temperature. The highest Seebeck coefficients were measured at low temperatures, about 3.5 mV per Kelvin, and the lowest Seebeck coefficients were measured at high temperatures, 0.5 mV per Kelvin. We have carried out the spectrophotometric studies of the solutions at different temperatures and found that the speciation of europium is temperature-dependent in water bromide ionic liquid mixtures. At the low temperatures, the water complexes of europium are predominant, and at the high temperatures, the bromide complexes are predominant. This competitive complexation of europium has a strong influence on the Seebeck coefficient. As conclusion, we may point on the high Seebeck coefficient values for europium solutions in the hydrated ionic liquids and the strong influence of the competitive complexation of transition metals on the Seebeck coefficient. This phenomenon could be further studied to improve the performance of thermocells. And I would like to thank my collaborators, the host institutions and the funding organization for the support of this work. And thank you very much for your attention.